Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I answer a question from a viewer who left me a comment on my video, Dr. Schultz's Nerve Formula. This question comes from Kathleen. So Kathleen, this video is for you. She asked me in the comments, thank you. Does anyone use this for helping the nervous system slash hypothalamus for things like CFS? And if you guys don't know what that is, I looked it up. CFS is chronic fatigue syndrome. So Kathleen, in this video, what I decided to do was I got you guys here at the desk and I looked up some, I did some digging. I looked up some websites and such like that. This formula, Dr. Schultz's Nerve Formula, can help with that. But what it's going to do is it's going to mainly work on the central nervous system, the nervous system in general. This is great for sedating, helping you to relax, mainly to help with sleep. But it can help with like aches and pains, tendonitis. So it's kind of like an herbal pain relief at the same time, as well as helping with things like seizures. But I looked up a website and I decided to just go through herbs that can help with CFS. So we'll just kind of keep this video really simple. We're just going to look at the herbs that will help with CFS. I'm sure that there's plenty of other supplements too that can help with that versus going the medical route, but we're just going to look at the herbs today. One that I came across, aside from this one that I'm looking at right now, mentioned ginseng. And one recommendation I could make for you, even though this is a male supplement, Dr. Schultz's Super Ginseng, it's only got a blend of ginsengs and Eartha Root, which I think is another version of ginseng. This is a male product, but ginseng helps with stamina. It can help with energy. It helps with endurance and vitality. This herb also helps by working on the immune system, so it can keep you healthy during cold and flu season. Say if you have a cold or flu, it can help you get over it a little bit more quickly. But it helps to stimulate the immune system. One part of this website, this is, I believe, a blog that this lady wrote about her chronic fatigue syndrome. I like this little bit that she wrote about skullcap, but there's a whole list of herbs that we'll go ahead and go through. And I'll also talk about this product too here. But, and actually, this herb that I'm about to read about, it has, it's called skullcap or Scutellaria latiflora. Maybe saying that herbal name wrong, but the nerve formula has skullcap in the mixture, along with valerian root, lobelia, wild yam, black cohosh, blue cohosh, hops flower, passion flower. And then this is all set in a base of organic grain alcohol, distilled water, and unfiltered raw apple cider vinegar. That's why it also has a weird smell and taste. But this little bit of skullcap, so this is what her results were. Skullcap turned out to be something of a miracle for her. She had hyperinsomnia, need for a lot of sleep her entire life. 10 hours of sleep made her somewhat functional when she was better, but she was up to 12 to 15 hours a night as she declined. Her ability after a few days of taking skullcap to sleep a normal 8 to 9 hours left her, she said in a state of shock. Even months later, she said that she'd hardly believed this lifelong issue had been resolved with an herb. Let's see here. Another thing she started doing too, and I would encourage other people in the other viewers too, as she started feeling better, she began to work out at a low anaerobic threshold, starting with 5 minutes of relaxation and exercise, then moving up to 12 minutes, then 15, 17, 20. She's now up to an hour with no crash days. Pacing was important, and she makes a point of doing 5 minutes of relaxation exercises every hour to get those intrusive, energy-draining thoughts out of her head. So also working out will help with chronic fatigue syndrome, so I wanted to get that out of the way. We'll go ahead and just go down the list of what her herbal treatment protocol was. Antiviral, antibiotic, immune support, Ashwagandha root powder, cacao powder, ginger, lemon balm tea, mistletoe tea, turmeric ground, grounded turmeric. Let's see here. Circulation, cayenne pepper, garlic or garlic powder, ginkgo biloba tea, horse chestnut tincture. Added to body oil and rubbed into legs. So you could rub this on your legs, is what it's saying for the protocol. Mitochondrial support, grapeseed oil for coenzyme Q10, or you could just take the supplement coenzyme Q10, CoQ10. It's adding nervous system, chamomile tea, red bush tea, skullcap tea, St. John's wort tea, valerian tea, vervain tea, and then for gut flora support, we have caraway seed ground. I will leave a link for you guys in the video, just not to make this too long, in the description, so that way you guys can look at this. But you can blend this into a tea. You can ground up these herbs, put them into capsule forms, and that's about it. So this website, I wanted to give them a shout out, healthrising.org. This was specifically for a lady that was struggling with CFS. So yeah. All right, Kathleen, I hope that this video answers your question. I didn't want to make this video too long, but this formula by itself will help regenerate your nervous system and help you to have healthy sleep if that's something that you're struggling with, and to wake up at normal times during the day to relax you and sedate you enough. But just skullcap alone, which is in this formula, will help with that. I was looking over a Dr. Christopher lecture too, and hops flower is great for repairing the nerves by themselves. And altogether, synergistically, this is going to rehabilitate your nerves and help you get better. So that's just another thing about those two herbs. But just skullcap tea alone was helping this lady. So, I mean, there's an answer for you. And then, like I said earlier, ginseng, you could either get this product or you could get a form of ginseng and start drinking that and using that. I think it's great in a tincture or doing like a ginseng shot. You can find those at health food stores or drinking a ginseng tea. So that'll just help your energy to come back up and help you to have healthy sleep patterns. So, all right, you guys, that's it for the video. Thanks for watching, Kathleen. I hope this answers your question, and thank you for the comment. I'll talk to you guys soon.